I'm your host, Dr. Joe Dispenza. Let's begin.
My question is, as I understand from quantum physics, the observer creates the reality. Therefore, is there any correlation between the time it takes for a thought to become matter in our lives and how long it takes to create new neuropaths to be able to perceive and observe the reality we want?
Laura, thank you so much for your question. Gosh, I'm going to see if I can answer this without getting too far down the rabbit hole here. So quantum physics absolutely says that we are somehow the observers of our lives. Now, I want to be really clear. The observation is you directing your attention to an outcome. So when Einstein and Planck were disturbing subatomic particles in metals, they were expecting on some level to see those electrons fall closer towards the nucleus of the atom in the same way that an apple falls from a tree, moving a smaller body towards a larger body in a very, very predictable and linear way. Like an apple falling from a tree, you can actually predict when it's going to land if you know the speed and the distance. So you can determine the time it's going to take. So when they did that and they looked for the outcome, somehow that's not what occurred. It was more like, instead of going down the stairs or taking the elevator, you went from one floor to the next without passing through the other floors. And this kind of unpredictable world of the quantum became this whole understanding that matter is actually just packets of energy, just quantas or collections of frequencies. And matter is that slowest frequency. And so you see electrons appearing and disappearing based on the atom's ability to stabilize, to stay stable. And somehow when they did the measurements, subjective mind had an effect on the objective world. In other words, everywhere they looked for the electron to appear, somehow it would appear. So they realized the observer, that mind and matter were implicitly connected on some level, that it was impossible to separate the two. And when they looked for that subatomic particle, that electron, it went from a cloud of waves, a cloud of probabilities, where it could be anywhere. That wave function collapsed and energy became matter. And when they turned their back and no longer observed it, that matter went back into energy, back into probability, back into possibility. So they saw that subjective mind has an effect on the objective world, but only for the very tiny, for atoms and electrons and photons and subatomic particles, but not for the very large, not like for real life events in our life, because everything, that is real life in terms of matter, the moon rotating around the Earth, all of these principles of large bodies somehow are under some law of classical or Newtonian physics, and everything seems to work like a machine or like clockwork when you're looking at a lot of different large bodies in planets and solar systems, and et cetera. So, and then there's principles of how we operate in three-dimensional reality. And somehow the observer effect only works for the very tiny, but not for the very large. And the next question is, maybe we're just poor observers. Now, Einstein said it's not matter. It's not the particle that's creating particles. It's actually the field is the sole governing agency of the particle. And the field is rich with information, with frequencies. So then, fundamentally speaking, if you could get to the field and create from the field instead of from matter, in other words, you having to do something in your life, you have the thought of a vacation and then you got to work really hard and save money and plan for it and sacrifice and do all those things, and you can set the date and you can have the vacation, but you got to do a lot of things to have that experience in your life. You can still have it, but you got to work really hard and do play the game. Okay, so what about creating from the field instead of from matter? If you could create from the field instead of from matter, and the field is actually what creates matter, if you could change enough information in the field, can you change the experience, the outcome in three-dimensional reality? Now, creating from the field instead of from matter, there are some fundamental principles that we have to get to. And first thing is that you have to get to the field. And in order for you to get to the field, you got to forget about everything physical and material, take your attention off it, and take your attention off everything known, or more, everything that you associate as knowns in your life. The act of becoming pure consciousness, we discovered that when you can take all of your attention off your body, all the people in your life, all the objects and things you own, all the places you've lived, the places you need to be, the place you're sitting, not think about the past or the future, but relax into the present moment. That moment you dissociate from everything known, everything physical and material, is the moment you become pure consciousness. That is passing through the door from three-dimensional reality to four-dimensional reality. That is when you start getting to that fourth dimension called time, the present moment. We call that getting beyond yourself. Now, once you cross through that door, the game changes. You're not that character that you think you are in three-dimensional reality. You're consciousness. And in that realm of the quantum, that is that invisible field of energy that's unifying everything physical and material, there's no separation. Things tend to be connected. So the thought of what you want produces the feeling of having it in the quantum. The thought of your abundance or your vacation in three-dimensional reality produces the feeling of not having it, the lack or the separation of not having it. In the quantum, you got to feel it to experience it. So if you're truly in the quantum and you have a coherent brain and coherent heart, and the thought is the signal out into the field, and the feeling is the magnetic charge that draws the event back to you, if you can get beyond space and time, and when there is no space, there can't be time, because of space, there's separation. If you can get to that point of the quantum where everything is frequency, everything is energy, everything is vibration, everything is resonance, everything is information, everything is thought, everything is consciousness, and every thought has a frequency in that realm, there's infinite possibilities in that realm, you move to that realm called time-space. Now, time in this place tends to be eternal. At times is standing still. You have an infinite amount of time in this realm. And with an infinite amount of time, you have an infinite number of possibilities that you could experience. In that realm called the quantum, if we get closer and closer to that zero-point field, that point of singularity, that oneness, wholeness, pure consciousness, pure love, the absolute, whatever you want to call it, source, if you're moving closer and closer towards it, you feel more wholeness. Bohm called it undivided wholeness. And if you get closer and closer to source, there's less separation between you and it. And the less distance that you have between you and source, the shorter amount of time it takes for things to appear in your life. So then when you create from the field instead of from matter, you could exert greater effects on larger things that could take place in your life. And when there's enough information in the field that actually creates the outpicturing or the hologram to take place in three-dimensional reality, that's the experience of your vacation, the experience of your wealth, the experience of your healing, the experience of your mystical moment. But here's the deal. We can't try to predict anything about that experience, because the predictive process is us putting a known over the unknown. It truly has to come in a way that we can't predict. That is the moment we're no longer expecting it to be a way that we know. That is the unknown. So creating from the field instead of from matter, if we balance between intention, the intention of our future, and the surrender and the trust to the outcome, if we're continuously creating from the field instead of from matter and monitoring our responses to the environment that causes us to return back to the old self, to the past, if we do that properly, then we could actually shorten the distance between the thought of anything we want and the experience of having it. And creating from the field instead of from matter is exactly what allows us to do this. So take a coherent brain. You got a good signal that's going out into the field. The information is very, very clear. Have a coherent heart, and now you got a strong magnetic signature. The stronger you feel the love for your creation before, and the emotions of it before it happens, when you do that from the field, somehow you tend to bring events to you. And when you change your energy enough times and it becomes familiar to you, there's a vibrational match between you and that future. The cool part is that these events, these synchronicities and opportunities begin to come to you. And it's those synchronicities that actually reaffirm the belief that you are the creator of your life. And so you can shorten the distance between the thought of what you want and the experience of having it if you create from the field instead of from matter.